Hello students, good morning. We are learning your topic current electricity. In previous video lecture, we have discussed about the resistance and Ohm's law. What is the resistance? The definition of resistance we have seen in previous video lecture. Okay, and what is the Ohm's law? Ohm's law is all about the flow of current in the wire and the potential difference in the wire. That one is nothing but the Ohm's law shows relationship between the flow of electron through the wire and the potential difference between that two ends of the wire. Okay, and this shown by scientist Ohm, and therefore the law is known as Ohm's law. And what is the resistance? We have already seen just introduction about resistance. In this video lecture, we deeply discuss about what is mean by resistance and what is the resistivity. See, what is the resistance? Resistance is opposite to voltage. See, in first or second video lecture, I have told you the current electricity is what related to the flow of electron. Okay, why the electrons start to flow? Because of voltage. Voltage move electron in forward direction, while the resistance oppose the flow of electron. So what is the definition of resistance? Resistance is opposite to current. Okay, resistance is opposite to current. Therefore, the definition of resistance is nothing but it is capacity of conductor to oppose or to resist the flow of electron. Are you getting this? Got it? What is the resistance? Resistance opposite to current. Current means the flow of electron. Resistance means stop movement of that electron. Why the electron stop to move from one end to another end? Because of the resistance. So resistance we can define, it is the capacity of conductor to oppose, to resist the flow of electron through the conductor. So the definition of resistance is, resistance is capacity of conductor to oppose the flow of electrons. Flow of electrons. Okay, see, here is the resistance and here I can write the resistivity. See, what is resistance? Resistance is denoted by letter R. And what about the resistivity? We will see after some time. Okay, so what is the definition? Definition of resistance is, resistance is capacity of conductor to oppose the flow of electron. See, resistance in previous video lecture, that one is nothing but the Ohm's law. We can see the relation between current and potential difference. In that we can see, if what is the statement for Ohm's law? The statement for Ohm's law is, if the physical conditions of the conductor is constant, then current flowing through that wire and potential difference created between that two wire are directly proportional to each other. See what the word here, if the physical states of conductor is constant. Okay, what is the physical states of conductor? First one is the length, second one is the temperature, third one is the cross sectional area, and fourth one is the material. If these physical states of conductor are constant, then the current flowing through the wire and the potential difference created in that wire are directly proportional to each other, said by the scientist Ohm. So if, see, the length, temperature, cross sectional area, these are known as the physical state of conductor, and last one is the material. Okay, if such physical states are constant, then what is the difference between, what is the relation between current and potential difference? We have already seen. See, depend on this physical state, resistance is depend. See, resistance is changed when this physical states are changed. Means resistance is depend upon these four physical quantities, okay, resistance depend upon length, resistance depend upon temperature, resistance depend upon cross sectional area, resistance depend upon material, then what kind of dependence or what is the relation between this physical state and resistance? See, resistance is directly proportional to length, therefore I can write here R is directly proportional to N. And all of you know that. What is the meaning of directly proportional? See, if L is increases, R is also increases. If L decreases, R also decreases. Means length increases, resistance is also increases. Length goes on decreasing, resistance also goes on decreasing. See, I have two copper wires. Okay, first have length, this one, and second having length higher than first one. This is the first copper wire and this is the second copper wire. See what happened? Larger the length, larger the resistance. Smaller the length, smaller the resistance. So I can write here resistance is directly proportional to L, whereas resistance is inversely proportional to student's cross-sectional area. R is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area. See how cross-sectional area means breadth. You can say breadth. And the proportion in between these is inversely proportional. Means cross-sectional area increases, resistance decreases. Cross-sectional area decreases, resistance goes on increasing. Then what is mean by resistivity? So the definition of resistivity, resistivity is nothing but the, it is also one kind of resistance of conductor, but which having unit length and cross-sectional area. What I say, if here is the equation number 1, here is the equation number 2. What is the definition for resistivity? Resistivity, it is a one kind of resistance of conductor having unit length, having unit length and cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area. So what is the word here? It is one kind of resistance. Resistivity what? It is also one kind of resistance having unit length. See, having unit length and cross-sectional area. See this equation, can we combine these two equation? Yes, we can combine these two equation, because resistivity is what? Resistivity is one kind of resistance which having unit length and having cross-sectional area. So by combining equation 1 and 2, by combining equation 1 and 2, we got the equation number 3, and that one is nothing but, what is the our equation number 1? R is proportional to L, whereas equation number 2, R is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area. By combining these two equation, we have R is proportional to L and it is inversely proportional to A, and this is known as students resistivity of conductor. So I remove this proportionality constant and I will write here L upon A. So this is known as resistivity. So resistivity what? It is resistance of conductor which having unit length and cross-sectional area. See, from this equation we can calculate the equation for resistivity. This symbol is known as student rho. This symbol is known as rho, and this is also known as symbol for resistivity. Okay, therefore by this equation, from this equation number 3, we can calculate the equation for resistivity. Therefore resistivity rho is equal to Ra upon L. This is known as resistivity. See, now we are going to calculate the unit for resistivity. Okay, this is the resistance and this is the resistivity. What is the resistance? Resistance is denoted by letter R and the resistivity is denoted by letter rho. Okay, so what is the resistance? Is the capacity of conductor to oppose the flow of electron. Whereas resistivity is the one kind of resistance having unit length and cross sectional area. Now see, we are going to discuss about what is the difference between these two. Okay, see, what is difference between resistance and resistivity? See, first of all, when we write difference, we can write or we usually write the definition. Okay, first of all, the first point is the definitions of both these two. What is the definition for resistance? Capacity of conductor to oppose the flow of electron. Here is the, it is one kind of resistance having unit length and cross sectional area. See, the point number 2 in a difference is nothing but the resistance is shown by symbol, resistance is shown by symbol, what symbol? Using R. Whereas resistivity is shown by using symbol, which symbol? Rho. Okay, now what is the formula for resistance? In previous video lecture, when we have seen the Ohm's law, we have the formula for R. R is equal to resistance is equal to V upon I. That one is nothing but the potential difference upon current according to Ohm's law. And here we got the second formula for resistance is nothing but the R is equal to rho L upon A. Okay, what about the formula for resistivity? What is the formula for resistivity? Resistivity is equal to Ra upon L. Now we are going to calculate the units for resistance and resistivity. The unit for resistance we have already seen. What is the unit for resistance? The unit for resistance is Ohm. All of you know that. The point number 4 is unit. Unit of resistance is Ohm, shown by this symbol. Whereas what is the unit for resistivity? The unit for resistivity is Ohm meter. How this can be calculated? See, what is the formula for resistivity? Resistivity is equal to Ra upon L. So what is R? R is the resistance. The unit for resistance is Ohm. A is cross sectional area. What is the unit for cross sectional area? Is meter square divided by length. What is the unit for length? Unit for length is a meter. The 1 m from these 3, here is the 2, here is the 1. 1 getting cancelled. Therefore, what will be remain here? Ohm meter. Therefore, the unit for resistivity is Ohm meter. And the last point is nothing but, which is very very important, resistance is depend upon 4 things. See, resistance is depend upon which I have already told you. The first one is the length, second one is the cross sectional area, third one is the temperature, and the fourth one is the material. See what happened in case of these two. When these 4 entity goes on changing, or when these 4 entities changes, resistance is also changes. Therefore, resistance is depend on these 4 entities. While material is same, if the material is same, therefore if the material is same, these quantities change. But resistivity is not upon these 4 quantities. It is depend only on material. See, it is not depend on length, it is not depend on cross sectional area, it is not depend upon the temperature. It is depend only which kind of material of conductor having resistivity changes. If material is same, resistivity is same. Material changes, resistivity goes on changing. Okay, this is the basic difference between resistance and resistivity. Now we will stop here. Remaining part we'll see in next lecture.